If you're at your 60 or 30-day Fastpass booking window, now what? How do you know which rides to book a Fastpass for? Today, I'll tell you why you need to book a Fastpass, which rides you actually need a Fastpass for, and how to prioritize your rides so you can get the Fastpasses you want before others snap them up. Hi, I'm Holly, and welcome to It's a Great Disney Day. If you're new to the channel, be sure and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you're notified when I upload my next video. Be sure and check us out on Facebook at It's a Great Disney Day. Let's get rolling. It's hard for me to believe, but some people, especially new people to Disney, don't book fast passes. Understanding the tier systems and which rides you actually need a fast pass for can be overwhelming, but you really need to book those fast passes because some rides have up to 3 and 4 hour waits. Just by fast passing a couple of rides, you can dramatically decrease your wait time throughout the day and get so much more done. So here are a few suggestions to help you decide which rides to Fastpass. 1. Watch some YouTube POV videos with your family so you know which rides to put on your tour plan. Number 2. Realize you can't do it all, so know which attractions are on your must-do list. Number 3 is to know which rides are very popular, because popular rides equal long wait times. And those will be the attractions you want a Fastpass. Number 4. Let's talk about dealing with popular rides that you don't have a Fastpass for. Plan to arrive an hour before park opening and ride attractions you don't have a Fastpass for during the first hour. If you're booking at the 30-day mark, there may only be Fastpasses left for less popular attractions. So making early arrival for rope drop a priority will help you get to the more popular rides before the majority of the crowd arrives. So it might be a good idea to ride everything in the standby line in the morning, take a midday break, book your fast passes for the early evening or later in the day, and ride some of the popular rides in the standby line closer to park closing. Crowds are usually a little lower at that time. So, which attractions do you actually need a fast pass for? I'll give you the top 3 attractions, park by park, and maybe a few extra. But if they're not on my list, you're most likely not going to need a Fastpass to enjoy this attraction. Let's start at Magic Kingdom. The top 3 attractions are Seven Dwarves Mine Train, Peter Pan, and Space Mountain, with Splash Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, and Jungle Cruise close behind. And all 6 can have extremely long wait times. At Magic Kingdom, there are no tier systems, so you can book any 3 of the 25 attractions that offer Fastpass Plus. So for the rides that you don't have a Fastpass for, you will have to wait in a line. But wait times for all attractions vary greatly throughout the day. Knowing which attractions have the shortest wait times at any given point of the day will allow you to do way more on your trip. If you'd like more information on how to arrange the order of your attractions so you can decrease the amount of time you spend waiting in lines, leave me a comment below. Let's move on to Epcot. The Fastpass attractions here are divided into Tier 1 and Tier 2. Tier 1 includes the more popular attractions, plus a few extra, but the only ones that you really need a Fastpass for will be Test Track, Soarin', and Frozen Ever After. You're only allowed to book 1 Tier 1 attraction. So I suggest your plan be to book a Fastpass for Test Track, but at rope drop, go straight to Soarin'. Right after Soarin', ride Frozen Ever After. The World Showcase doesn't open until 11 o'clock. However, due to the popularity of Frozen Ever After, they do open that ride at 9 a.m. But a lot of people don't know that. After a ride on Frozen, head over to your Fastpass at Test Track. Having a 2-day visit at Epcot alleviates the question of which Tier 1 attraction to Fastpass. You're allowed to select 2 attractions from the Tier 2 category. The ones you might need a Fastpass for would include Spaceship Earth and Turtle Talk with Crush. Lines for the other Tier 2 attractions are rarely more than a 15-minute wait early in the day. At Hollywood Studios, the Tier 1 selections include all 3 of the Toy Story Land rides, Slinky Dog Dash, Toy Story Mania, and Alien Swirling Saucers. The best choice for a Fastpass here is Slinky Dog Dash. For an extra tip, if you book your Fastpass for Slinky Dog, At around 9:30, you can go ahead and go straight to Toy Story Mania and then Alien Swirling Saucers with very little wait, and then head over to your Fast Pass for Slinky Dog Dash. This way you can really decrease your wait times. The best use of your Fast Passes for Tier 2 attractions here will be Tower of Terror, Rock and Roller Coaster, and the Frozen Sing-Along Celebration. On August 29th, when Galaxy's Edge opens, the Millennium Falcon will be the only opening day attraction. Fast Passes will not be an option, so this is going to be an attraction to ride at Rope Drop until they add it to the Tier 1 category. At Animal Kingdom, both Tier 1 attractions are in Pandora. Flights of Passage is going to be the attraction with the longest wait of any ride in Disney World, so it's best to grab a Fast Pass for it. But if it's not available, get a Fast Pass for Navi River Journey and just go straight to Flights of Passage and ride it first at Rope Drop. Just like at the other parks, you can only book one Tier 1 attraction and two Tier 2 attractions. Your two best choices for Fast Passes in the Tier 2 category are Expedition Everest and Kilimanjaro Safari. And for a bonus tip, if you arrive early for Rope Drop, this park is easily toured with little to no wait. Here's a few suggestions so you get those important Fast Passes booked first. Set your alarm so that you're ready to book at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, because many other people will be doing the same thing. Don't worry about booking your Fast Passes on a particular date or at a particular park. Book them based on the order of popularity. Here's my list of the top 10 attractions. Book Fast Passes for these attractions first, and then move on to any remaining attraction Fast Passes. So what are some of your best tips and tricks when it comes to booking Fast Passes? Leave them in the comments below. Well, I hope this has been helpful for you. If it has, give it a thumbs up and be sure and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great Disney day. See ya!